everybody, and welcome to Quick Pitch presented by Snapple. I'm Jackie Redmond. But first, let's take a look at some former Cy Young Award winners. Justin Verlander was going up against Zach Greinke in the rubber match of the Diamondbacks-Astros series in Houston. Versus Jacob DeGrom, a battle of two Cy Young candidates. I mean, the headline for Sunday's rubber match between the Sox and Mets, it pretty much writes itself. These two starters do, after all, hold the top two ERAs amongst pitchers who've thrown at least 140 innings. But of course, nobody's perfect, right? The argument against DeGrom, his 8-9 win-loss record isn't exactly what I'd call sparkling. In fact, no Cy Young starter has ever had a record below 500. As for Sale, it's the workload. Thanks to a couple of stints on the DL, Sale has only pitched 147 innings. For those of you at home interested in what history has to say about that, the fewest innings pitched by a Cy Young starter in a non-strike year is 198 1/3. Now, these two have never actually faced each other in the majors, if you can believe that, but they do have a little bit of history. Yes, this right here is Mr. Shows. Oh, but the under-the-radar move was actually sneaky good, and it's been paying off for Oakland. In seven starts since that deal, the righty is 5-0 with a 2.72 ERA. And most importantly, the team is a perfect 7-0. Now, Fires might already have a World Series ring, but he didn't get to play in the postseason for the Stros. I got a feeling his role with the A's is going to be a little bit bigger come October. A's taking on the Rays on Sunday. Well, anyone that's played sports knows that you can't get through a rookie season in any league, let alone the majors, without experiencing some sort of initiation. Which brings me to the Minnesota Twins, who opted to hold a race. But it wasn't just any race. Oh no, a race where all of the rookies had to dress up in horse and jockey costumes. This is a real thing. And this is the best part. Apparently, that was just leg one. So stay tuned. Maybe next leg, they have to dress up as something else. If you've never heard of Haley Dawson and her hashtag journey to 30, allow me to catch you up. Haley was born with Pollen syndrome, which caused some of the fingers on her hand to be underdeveloped. But thanks to students and faculty at UNLV, Haley has a robotic hand that allows her to both grasp and throw. So, Haley